In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to build a synth solo with Ableton Live and Omnisphere and the push. And let me show you what I've got here. We'll be building something similar to this. This is the synth solo finished. So this solo is made with Omnisphere, and all the modulations here are mapped to Ableton's instrument rack. So let's close this one now. I'm going to disable. I have a new track here ready. And with an instance of Omnisphere preloaded with a patch, Sweet Comper. So if I play it here, I have the repeat option enabled here on the push, 16 notes. Okay, so this is the sound of the patch without doing anything to it. Before I go on modulating Omnisphere, let me show you a max MIDI effect that's called CC Map 8, which maps MIDI controllers to knobs here. So we can set it to 1, which is modulation, and the modulation will control Omnisphere. Modulation is the modulation wheel that keyboards usually have, synthesizers, and Omnisphere has built-in modulations and controls that are already mapped to these standard keyboard modulations like the modulation wheel. So, like if I play here, we can see that this one is already changing the filter, it's making it brighter. So I'm going to group these two together by pressing Command G. I select both and then I group them, and that creates an instrument rack. Now when I select my instrument rack here, I have 4 macros on the push. I want the first macro to modulate this parameter, which will be the modulation wheel. So then I have it here now. Okay, and I'm going to rename this Command R, this to mod for modulation. Okay, next I'm going to open Omnisphere and I'm going to check this other. I like that one. So I go back to Ableton, I click configure. I want to bring that parameter there so I can control it. Then I press right click, enable host automation. I move it and it appears there. Okay. Close configure now. I press right click again and I'm going to map that to macro number 2. Let me close Omnisphere. And this is the filter resonance, which is usually labeled as Q as a shortcut. So now I have the modulation, which is already controlling the frequency cut. And I have Q, which is controlling the resonance. So let's try it here. Frequency here, and then with the resonance. Okay. Now you can hear that after I release, it's very dry. I am going to add an echo effect just to give it a bit of a tail. So audio effects, echo. Let me add here the echo effect, dry wet. Okay, that's nice. Go back to instrument. And then I'm going to go here from the track. Let's hear this. I have the MIDI pattern here. This is what we're going to be. This is what we're going to be playing with. And I'm going to make it shorter here for this video, just these bars. Close these, have more space. And then let's go all the way to zero for the recording. My cursor is here. And I hit record. Here we go. Okay, so I recorded the modulation parameter and the resonance. And now let me click here on add lane for each automated envelope and I will see both. Make them bigger so we can see. Have mod instrument rack, this is the frequency, and here you can see the resonance. So what I did here is I increase the frequency just linearly and I give it a little accentuation here and then I keep going. Once I'm all the way up, I bring up the resonance. So then when I go down with the frequency, with the resonant high, I get that acid kind of sound, the bubbly sound, the characteristic of analog synths. If I went down on the frequency without the resonance, maybe it won't be as interesting since I already had that kind of sound here. But now here on the second part of the solo, I have a new texture because I have the resonance up. And I have the tails here again, some accents. Okay, let's listen to some parts. Let's listen to this accent here. So I want to make this a bit more intense, so. I want this to extend a little bit, to echo more. So this is a technique that I use. And I'm going to create another echo here, echo effect. I'm going to set it to 100%. Add it to a group, Command G. Let's label it Echo Send. So basically I'm creating a send effect, but inside the track. So I'm not sending it to the global send effect. And this is 100% echo, so I'm going to call this wet, since it's 100% wet. And then I'm just going to create another chain and call it dry. Okay, so now I will have both of them playing at the same time. Set the feedback to 90 or here. Okay, I stopped it there. So yeah, we don't want this all the time. Just here, just when the accent happens, I want to send to this echo. So I add a utility effect just before, and I map it, I map the gain to the first macro of this rack. And then I set it from mute to zero. So this is my echo send. Now this is inside my other instrument rack all the way here. I'm going to once again map this to macro 3, echo send. Okay, oh, so pretty now when I close it, we don't see all the details. So I'm just going to create this dramatic effect by sending it here like this. Okay, we see it here. And I go back to them. Let me add some reverb to the echo send. Let's try. Where is that not showing? Okay, here it is. That's my echo send. So you can listen there. And now let's do a bit more of a tweak here on this part, second part, when the resonance is all the way high. I want a bit more there, more resonance. So let me open Omnisphere again. Omnisphere, this patch here has multiple layers. I'm only modulating the resonance of layer A, but I have another wave here, another layer B and layer C, which also have resonance filter each. So I'm going to map these two as well. Okay, configure is on. Again, I go to B, right click, enable host automation. I move it there, it appears, to C. Enable host automation. I move it, it appears. Okay. Close it, I close it. And now I will map this as well to Q. Q, Q. Okay, so Q now will change the resonance of the three layers. Let's see how that sounds. Okay, I like that. And I will go back to my instrument. I will send, I will add a bit of a send effect here of the echo that I created on this part. Okay, so here I was just feeling these parts and sending a bit to my echo effect on these parts where I like the sound of it. So I wanted to accentuate and repeat, create create a tail for these parts. So that's why I sent the heckling. And here on the drop as well. And finally, because the solo is ending here, and I want a longer tail for a smoother transition, then I increase it all the way there, the echo send, so that let us have a long tail at the end. Okay, you can hear the reverb. I'm going to take out the reverb just a bit. It's a little too much. I'm just going to make it very little. Let me try again. Okay, that's it. Let's hear it from the beginning. That's it. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. By the way, this track is from an upcoming EP we have with Tuche, so it will be coming up later this year. If you want to hear some of our music, please visit our YouTube page, and I'll be making more of these tutorials, so stay tuned.